So what I'll do is I'll start by providing you with a broad overview of Indian Navy's major operational activities over the last year, and then highlight plans for the future. And thereafter, I'll take any questions that you have.
Subscribe and press bell icon. Never miss another update.
So you would be aware that we had recalibrated our operational deployment philosophy 2 years ago with an aim to enhance our presence and mission readiness across our areas of maritime interest in the Indian Ocean region. So I'm pleased to share with you that not only has this resulted in increasing our footprint and strategic domain awareness of the vast maritime expanse of the Indian Ocean region, but also enabled rapid deployment of our units to address emerging security challenges across the region, including HADR assistance to IOR littorals. We've also tailored our maintenance and training philosophy to support this operational pattern. Indian Navy also remains steadfast in its commitment towards curbing the menace of maritime piracy in the Gulf of Aden. This has been going on since 2008, and so far 75 Indian naval warships have been deployed, which have safely escorted more than 3,440, including 413 Indian flagged ships, with over 25,062 Indian mariners embarked. So thus far, Indian Navy has thwarted 44 piracy attempts and apprehended 120 pirates. This is a visible demonstration of our efforts towards guaranteeing safe and secure seas. In addition to the anti-piracy deployment, Indian Navy was also one of the first maritime forces to respond to the security situation in the Gulf of Hormuz earlier this year, the Straits of Hormuz earlier this year. Ever since, we have maintained an unbroken presence in the region, escorting approximately 82 lakh tons of cargo on board 74 Indian flagged merchant vessels. Even as I speak, one of our ships is deployed in the Straits of Hormuz to reassure our merchant marine and enhance security in the region as part of Operation Sankalp. So what we've been able to operationally achieve across this expanse of maritime theater has been largely due to the combat skills honed during major exercises. This year, we exercised our composite combat capability through Navy's largest biennial war game, that is the theater level operational readiness exercise. We call it Tropics 19. I must also share with you that the active participation of combat elements from Indian Army, Indian Air Force and Indian Coast Guard facilitated refining of our operational plans, addressing our op logistics issues and integrating the three services in conduct of large-scale joint operations across multiple theaters. Also, as part of Tropics, we conducted a pan-India coastal defense exercise Sea Vigil. Through this endeavor, we were able to test the robustness of our entire coastal security apparatus, and based on its effectiveness, MOD has also approved institutionalization of Sea Vigil on a biennial basis. And in keeping with this momentum, we also would be conducting Exercise Paschim Leher on the western seaboard from end Jan to end Feb 2020, simulating a conflict or contingency on the Western Maritime Theater. So this is about operations. Indian Navy also actively participates in numerous regional maritime exercises with our friendly foreign countries. From a rather conservative figure of 8 exercises in 2015, we are now participating in close to 30 bilateral or multilateral exercises. In addition, under the Government of India's overall ambit of neighborhood first policy, the Navy also undertook joint EEZ patrols of Maldives, Seychelles, Mauritius, as well as coordinated patrols in Bangladesh, Myanmar, Thailand and Indonesia. Maiden bilateral exercise with Bangladesh and Qatar, and a trilateral exercise with Singapore and Thailand were also commenced this year. The maiden bilateral exercise with Saudi Arabia is also scheduled early next year. We continue to be proactive in rendering assistance during large-scale national calamities as part of our HADR mandate. Be it Cyclone Foni, which made landfall in Odisha, severe floods in Maharashtra, Karnataka and Goa, or the rescue of stranded passengers on the Mahalakshmi Express in Mumbai. Naval personnel and assets are once again come together to provide succor to those who need. Navy also rendered assistance in our maritime neighborhood during the times of natural disasters. When this severe tropical revolving storm Idai hit Mozambique in March this year, our units were quickly on site providing relief support and communications to Port Beira, which had been cut off from the rest of the world. In fact, our Navy was the first to reach there. Towards enhancing the response mechanism in case of large-scale natural calamities, we conduct an annual joint HADR exercise. This year it was conducted in August at Chennai. So in addition to large-scale domestic participation, we also get foreign observers. So we had 14 foreign observers from 8 friendly foreign countries participating in this exercise. We also aim to enhance interoperability between the navies of the region. Last year, the Indian Navy hosted the 10th edition of Milan at Port Blair. And taking this initiative further, in March next year, the Indian Navy will be hosting the Milan 2020 as a multilateral exercise at Vishakhapatnam. The event is scheduled to witness participation of approximately 41 countries, bringing together maritime forces from all over the region and beyond. Last year, as you know, we commissioned the International Information Fusion Center at Gurugram to further our commitment towards achieving collective maritime security in the Indian Ocean region, which is a collaborative construct that works with partners, and that includes countries as also international agencies. The center has commenced hosting international liaison officers from friendly foreign countries to further enhance interoperability in the maritime domain. Just a few words about force planning, force level planning and future acquisitions. You're already aware that Navy is fully committed to Make in India vision. Since December 2018, close to 88% of our contracts and acceptance of necessity by value have been concluded with or accorded to Indian vendors. The Navy's share of the defense budget, though, has declined from 18% in 2012 to approximately 13% in financial year 19-20. So we have projected our requirements to the government. Whilst we have done that, we remain committed to progress force modernization using available resources optimally. In the face of shortages, emphasis on prioritization, rationalization, and economy of expenditure. As you are again aware, Indian Navy has been at the forefront of self-reliance in defense production right since independence. Our commitment to this pursuit is seen by the fact that out of the 50 ships and submarines currently under construction, 48 are being built in Indian shipyards. And these include the aircraft carrier Vikrant, the P-15 Bravo class destroyers, P-17 Alpha class stealth frigates, offshore patrol vessels and the Scorpene class submarines. The last of the P-28 ASW corvette is scheduled for delivery by early next year. And the delivery of 4 additional P-8I maritime reconnaissance aircraft is scheduled in 2021. We've also contracted for 16 ASW shallow water craft and 36 aircraft, which include HAL-built 12 Dorniers, 16 ALH and 8 Chetak helicopters. Acceptance of necessity has also been accorded for 41 ships, 10 Kamov 31 helicopters, 24 multi-role helicopters and 6 additional P-8I aircraft. And under the government's strategic partnership model, we are pursuing the projects of 75 India submarines and the naval utility helicopters. The Navy's long-term capability plan envisages induction of 3 aircraft carriers so that 2 CBGs or carrier battle groups are available for dispersed deployment in the IOR at all times. The broad contours of the IAC-2, for your information, to be constructed in India, it will be a 65,000 catobar carrier with electric propulsion. So these broad contours have been formulated and the case will be processed for accord of AON. There has also been focused effort to enhance our in-house expertise in repair and upkeep of modern weapons and sensors. Towards this, two major armament repair facilities are being set up and are likely to be commissioned by sometime mid next year. To support our fleets to operate effortlessly over the entire Indian Ocean region, several marine and technical repair infrastructure projects are also being progressed. As you would be aware, the new dry dock was commissioned by the Honorable Raksha Mantri in September. This is a big step towards captive capability to dock our aircraft carriers. Phase 2 Alpha Project Seabird at Karwar is progressing well. Creation of a fully-fledged naval dockyard and associated infrastructure to accommodate more ships, number of ships and submarines is being undertaken during this phase, Phase 2 Alpha. Indian Navy has also commenced the process of indigenizing complex and high-end technology equipment. These are very important to us and which were presently being imported. These are marine diesel engines, power generators, shafting and propellers, with active participation of public and private sector industries. So our aim is to reduce import dependency and progressively increase indigenous content in our shipbuilding projects. A few words about our human resource and training. Whilst our focus remains on induction of new technology and state-of-the-art platforms, we are constantly at work to keep our HR policies in sync with the aspirations of men and women in the Navy and our operational imperatives. This year, we've also taken major strides in our quest towards migrating to online recruitment. Recruitment examinations for non-UPSC graduate entry officers and sailors entry have been completely migrated to an online process from this year onwards. We successfully conducted the maiden online Indian Navy civilian entrance test for naval civilians this year and are firmly on the path to expand the scope of centralized naval civilian recruitment at naval headquarters. Training also remains one of Navy's key focus areas. Here I would like to inform you that in addition to the wide spectrum of specialist training undertaken in-house at our training institutes, we also have a favored training destination for many of our friendly foreign countries. Based on requests being received, we have increased the number of training vacancies for foreign trainees over the past few years from 699 to 1,525. Another milestone for us has been the induction of women pilots in the MR stream, or Maritime Reconnaissance stream, which is the mainstream maritime surveillance wing of the Naval Air Arm. Three women officers have been selected to undergo pilot training. In fact, as you would be aware, yesterday Sub-Lieutenant Shivangi has successfully completed a Stage 2 training at Kochi, making her the first woman pilot of the Indian Navy. The other two officers of the batch would be graduating this month end. So in conclusion, ladies and gentlemen, in keeping with this year's Navy Week theme, which is silent, strong and swift, I would like to assure the nation that as the primary instrument of India's maritime power, the Indian Navy will continue to play a decisive role in providing effective response across the full spectrum of challenges in our maritime domain and ensuring national prosperity. And on behalf of all uniformed and civilian personnel of the Indian Navy, I take this opportunity to convey my best wishes to our countrymen on the occasion of Navy Day. Jai Hind, Shanavaran.
Thank you, sir.
If you like this video, give it a thumbs up, do share and subscribe, and don't forget to press the bell icon. Keep watching National Defense. Jai Hind, Vande Mataram.